was sent the spirit of evil to rescue man from the kingdom of darkness and bring him into the splendor of your kingdom of light. We pray for this child. Set him free from original sin. Make her thankful of your glory. Send your Holy Spirit to dwell with her. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We anoint you with the oil of salvation in the name of Christ our Savior. May he strengthen you with his power. Listen, praise forever and ever.
Amen.
Brothers and sisters, we now ask us to give this child new life in abundance in water and the Holy Spirit. Father, you give us grace through sacramental signs, which tell us of the wonders of your unseen power. In baptism, we use your gift of water, which you have made a new symbol of the grace you give us in this sacrament. At the very dawn of creation, your Spirit breathed on the waters, making them the wellspring of all holiness. The waters of the great flood you made a sign of the waters of baptism that make an end of sin and a new beginning of goodness. Through the waters of the Red Sea, you led Israel out of slavery, be an image of God's holy people, set free from sin by baptism. In the waters of the Jordan, your Son was baptized by John, anointed with the Spirit. You so willed that water and blood should flow from his side as he hung upon the cross. After his resurrection, he told his disciples, "Go out and teach all nations by baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit." Father, look now with love upon your church and unseal for her the fountain of baptism. By the power of the Spirit, give to the waters of this font the grace of your Son. You created men in your own likeness, cleansing from sin in a new birth to innocence by water and the Spirit. We ask you, Father, with your Son, to send the Holy Spirit upon the water of this font. May all who are buried with Christ in the death of baptism, rise first to the newness of life. We ask you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Dear Father, you have come here to present this child for baptism by water and the Holy Spirit. He is to receive the gift of new life from God who is love. On your part, you must make your constant care to bring her up in the practice of your faith. See that the divine life which God gives her is kept safe from the force of sin to grow always stronger in her heart. If you pray to make the bread to our Savior's consolation, renew now the vows of your own baptism, reject sin, profess your faith in Christ Jesus. This is the faith of the Church. This is the faith in which this child is about to be baptized. This time. So I ask you, and I ask the whole community, do you reject Satan?
I do.
And all his words?
I do.
And all his empty promises?
I do.
You believe in God the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth?
I do.
You believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was born of the Virgin Mary, was crucified, died and was buried, rose from the dead, and is now seated at the right hand of the Father?
I do.
You believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting?
I do.
Repeat after me. This is our faith.
This is our faith.
This is the faith of the Church.
This is the faith of the Church.
We are proud to profess it.
We are proud to profess it.
Christ Jesus our Lord.
In Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
So, Father, parents and guardians, it is your will that your child should be baptized in the faith of the Church, which we have all professed with you. Then we, oh, she's gonna cry. We're gonna be beautiful. Then we, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Everybody, amen. Jesus Christ has freed you from sin, giving you a new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and welcome you into his holy people. He now anoints you with the priest of salvation, as Christ was anointed priest, prophet, and king, so that you live always as a member of his body, sharing everlasting life.
Amen.
Amen. No practice. You can be like, what's this? You have become a new creation and have clothed yourself in Christ. See in this white garment the outward sign of your Christian dignity. Your family and friends to help you by what an example, bring that dignity unstained into the everlasting life of heaven.
Amen.
Amen. Parents and godparents, this light is entrusted to you to be kept burning brightly. This child of yours has been enlightened by Christ. She is to walk always as a child of the light, and she keeps the flame of faith alive in her heart. When the Lord comes, will she go out to meet him with all the saints in the heavenly kingdom? Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated.